Have you ever had one of those days where your brain just feels slow? You can't focus, your thoughts are scattered, and even small tasks feel harder than they should. A lot of people chalk that up to poor sleep, too much stress, which might be true, but there's something else that could be throwing you off that most people completely overlook. And that's dehydration. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I help you strengthen your mind, fortify your brain, and build resilience. Today, we're looking at how something as simple as drinking water can have a profound impact on your mental clarity, mood, and overall brain function. And we're not talking about extreme dehydration here. Just losing as little as 1 to 2% of your body's water can impair cognitive performance. And that's well within the range of what happens after a night of sleep without fluids or going too long without a drink during the day. So let's unpack why hydration matters so much for your brain and how to make it a resilient habit that fits seamlessly into your daily routine. Your brain is made up of about 73% water. It's a highly active, energy-demanding organ that depends on fluid balance to keep things running smoothly. And when that balance is off, your brain feels it before you do. Here's why that happens. Electrolyte balance is one of the first places dehydration shows up. Your neurons, those cells that communicate information throughout your brain and body, use electrical signals to talk to one another. That signaling depends on minerals like sodium and potassium, which are dissolved in water. Without enough fluid to carry those electrolytes, your nerve signaling slows down, and this can make your thoughts feel sluggish and your reflexes dull. Then there's neurotransmitter production. Water is actually required to synthesize brain chemicals like dopamine and serotonin, two of the most important players in regulating your mood and motivation. When you're underhydrated, your brain has a harder time producing and moving neurotransmitters around. And that can show up as irritability, low motivation, or even mild anxiety. Cerebrospinal fluid is another big one. This fluid surrounds your brain and spinal cord, acting like a shock absorber, but it also helps clear out waste and deliver nutrients. If your hydration is off, your brain's internal cleanup system slows down, and that can lead to fogginess, low energy, and poor memory consolidation. Another overlooked role of hydration is maintaining the blood-brain barrier, and this is your brain's security system. It filters out harmful substances and lets the good stuff come through. Dehydration can make this barrier less effective, leaving your brain more vulnerable to inflammation and toxins that impact long-term brain health. And lastly, brain volume itself is affected. When you're dehydrated, brain cells lose water and begin to shrink. And that sounds dramatic, and it is. This shrinkage can affect processing speed and memory, and it's part of why dehydration makes you feel like your brain is just literally shrinking under pressure. All of this helps explain why your mental sharpness, focus, and emotional regulation take a hit long before you ever feel physically thirsty. Now, you might be thinking, I drink when I'm thirsty. Isn't that enough? The problem is, thirst isn't always a reliable signal, especially under stress. When you're in go mode, rushing through your morning or powering through a packed schedule, your brain shifts into task-focused survival mode and can suppress thirst cues because it's not a priority at the moment. Caffeine may also mask dehydration. It's a mild diuretic, meaning it makes you lose more fluid than you take in, but it also delays the signal that tells you to rehydrate. So that cup of coffee that you rely on to wake up your brain may be compounding the problem if it's not paired with water. And this is why we can't rely on thirst alone to stay properly hydrated. We have to build hydration into our routine so it becomes automatic. Let's shift into what you can actually do to make this easy and sustainable. Here are 5 tips for this. Number 1, start with morning hydration. When you wake up, your body is already mildly dehydrated. You've just gone 7 or 8 hours, hopefully, without any fluid. And yet, most people go straight to coffee. Try flipping that sequence. Before you reach for your coffee, drink a full glass of water. 12 to 16 ounces is ideal. This simple act helps regulate your brain and supports your cortisol awakening response, which is your body's natural energy surge in the morning. 2, pair drinking with something you already do. This is called habit stacking. Think of something that you do every morning without fail. brushing your teeth, letting the dog out, starting the coffee maker, link your water intake to that. So instead of saying, I need to remember to drink water, it just becomes part of your morning rhythm. You don't think about brushing your teeth, you just do it. So hydration can be that automatic too. I talked about the science of habit formation and how things become automatic 2 modules ago in this resilience podcast series. Go back and watch it if you haven't seen them. 3, use environmental cues. Out of sight, out of mind is real when it comes to water. Keep a visible water bottle on your desk or in your bag or wherever you spend most of your time. Choose one that you like. Seriously, this does make a difference. Something about a sleek or colorful bottle makes you more likely to use it. You can even set a gentle reminder on your phone or use a hydration app if that works for you. 4, make it appealing. If plain water isn't your thing, try flavor hacks. Add a slice of lemon or a few mint leaves or a splash of unsweetened juice. You're more likely to follow through when the experience is enjoyable. Just stay mindful, though, of added sugars or artificial flavors. And then 5, be consistent, not obsessive. You don't need to overdo it. Aim for about half your body weight in ounces of water per day. So if you weigh 150 pounds, that's roughly about 75 ounces. Of course, if you have a medical condition that restricts your fluid intake, then you need to check with your doctor about how much water you should drink a day. But if, going back to the example of 150 pounds being about 75 ounces per day, if you drink out of a 40-ounce cup, which are very popular these days, that size, then you just need to get through 2 of them in a day. And this isn't a hard rule, but it's a good starting point. Listen to your body and adjust based on your activity level and environment. And remember, if you're feeling tired, moody, or just mentally scattered, try water before reaching for caffeine or sugar. You might be surprised at how much better your brain feels after rehydrating, even just a little. So how does this tie into resilience? Resilience isn't just about bouncing back from big life events. It's about how well your brain functions under daily stress. And that depends on the little things that you do consistently, like keeping your brain properly fueled and hydrated. Hydration supports your prefrontal cortex, the part of your brain responsible for focus, decision-making, and impulse control. When that area is compromised, you're more likely to feel reactive, overwhelmed, or scattered. On the flip side, consistent hydration helps your brain regulate cortisol levels, recover faster from stress, and maintain the neurotransmitter balance you need for emotional stability and mental clarity. So while drinking water might feel like a small habit, it's a high-leverage one. We can call it a resilience multiplier. One small act has a ripple effect of better focus, mood, and even better choices throughout your day. If you're building a morning or daily routine for brain resilience, hydration is a great anchor habit. It takes very little effort, but the benefits compound over time. In our next video, we'll look at how to expand on these micro habits by creating a personalized self-care ritual, one that's not overwhelming, but strategic, designed to support your brain and emotional well-being consistently. If you're not subscribed to my channel, you should subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss it. You can think of today's takeaway as this. Before your coffee, grab a glass of water, link it to something you already do, and let that be your first resilience win of the day. If you found this helpful, let me know in the comments. Do you already have a hydration routine, or is this an area that you're ready to improve? I'd love to hear how you make it work into your own life. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks. Thanks for watching today, and I'll see you in the next video.